Hello my friends, Brett back, High Altitude Scale Modeling. Today we're going to look at this beautiful new release from Kinetic. I just got it from Japan yesterday. The CF-188A Royal Canadian Air Force Demo Team 2017 aircraft. If you've seen pictures of it on the internet, it's a beautiful paint scheme. Red, white, gray, wonderful markings. The sides you can see. Some of the information about the kit, what they did, some more pictures of the artwork. This side, nothing much different than just the cover picture. But, looks good. Canadian F-18s are a little different than American F-18s. I don't know the exact details. I don't think that's on the American one. And I'm sure there's someone out there who can give me more information. Put it in the comments below. There's obviously not going to be any weapons with this because it's part of the demo team. The main challenge is going to be getting the color red correct to match the decals. As you can kind of see, that looks a little bit different than that. And there's some fading gray area in there. Decals are by Cartograph. 280 plus parts. And let's take a look and see what they're giving us in the box. If you're familiar with Kinetic 18s, they're very good aircraft, very good model kits. They build up nice. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clear parts, fuselage part. More clear parts that have escaped from the bag. Oh no! Decals, which we'll look at the end. Instructions, which we'll also look at the end. Let me set this down here. Let's start with... excuse me. Let's start with the fuselage part. This is the bottom part of the fuselage. Bag's rolled up, and it is a resealable bag. And what you get is one finely molded, very sturdy piece of plastic. Nice rivet detail, nice landing gear bay detail for the front wheel. There's a few little ejector pins, sprue gates right there. I don't see any. Let me zoom you in. Don't see any sink marks. You save good rivet detail, good venting detail there. Rester hooks go in there. Some more very nice detail along the back, and along the front here. You see the inside. These are the top parts of the wings. So that's nice, they're molded in one. So, that's the bottom of the fuselage. Let's plot this really big sprue here. Let's get the top of the fuselage. Wing parts, looks like elevators. All right. Whoa. Sorry about that. Here's the overall sprue. Upper fuselage, top of the wings, the identification markings here on the front, leading edge slats and flaps, speed brake right here, goes back here, good detailing inside there. Inside, looks like the elevators are both just one piece. Very smooth plastic, no sink marks. Gonna get a good wash in there, except This thing's going to be so clean, you're not really going to weather it much. So, zoom back in, take a look at some of these parts. One of the elevators. Sorry, I keep wanting to chew the bag. One of the elevators. Left wing. Nice fine rivet detail. Good paneling. Speed brake. I'm thinking that's an aileron. That's a flap. Or it could be the other way around. These are going to be the bottom of the wings. You see the missile rails are connected. Bottom of the wings are there. Good detail. It does look to be... It's raised a little bit, so it's not really a sink mark. But that's going to be because these holes you're going to possibly take out. We won't know the instructions. There is a really nice Canadian, regular Canadian F-18 by Kinetic out there. So this is probably, almost certainly, the same kit. See the nice ridge detail, rivet detail. Another part of the wing. Now look down the fuselage. You've got some more excellent rivet detail. Go along the top here, nice venting. Hollow all the way through. Here's where the refueling probe goes, so you're probably going to be able to have that opened or closed. The box art may look like a single canopy, and this looks like it's made for a double cockpit. However, if you know the Kinetic kits, you know that they're all like this, and it just gives you a part that goes in there to make it the single seat version. All right. Next Sprue, it's got nose, tails, like ejector seats, or seat. Nice crispy bags, as you can tell. Alright, let's get an overall look at the Sprue. There you go. The nose, tails, separate rudders. Pylons. This is that part I was saying that goes over the back of the cockpit to make it a single seat. Ejector seat in halves. This goes around it for the canopy. Some good real fine detail in here. Looks like throttle and joystick. Good detail. Really good detail inside these doors. I don't see any ejector pins any place where they shouldn't be. Pylons or halves are going to go together. The legs have no little bit of burring right here. See that better on the close up. Instrument panel. Nice detail. I'm sure there's decals for that. Head on back in. So. Some doors, the pylons that are in two halves, part that goes over where the second seat would be. That's inside the landing gear bay, the main gear bay, and ejector seat. Finely detailed little parts here. There's the joystick, part of the ejection system right there. And then the instrument panel with its nice detail. Parts of the cockpit. Here's the landing gear. The main gear. Struts. You can see maybe just the tiniest little bit of burring, but not a lot. The tails are in one section. One piece. So are the rudders, which is just going to slide right on there. Here's the nose cone for the left side, I think. I'm assuming it's probably another part for the other side. And then this part here goes around the canopy so you can have the single seat version. Alright. Next up, we've got wheel wells, front landing gear strut, more parts to the ejection seat, do like these resealable bags. There's two sprues in here. Let's start with this one because it's got the cockpit tub, landing gear bay. There you go, overall view of it. Another instrument panel, I guess because, you know, two-seat version. Ejection seat parts, first stage compressor fans, landing gear bay, struts. Looks like there's no burring on the front landing gear strut. Fuel probe, sides to probably the main gear bay. Actually, there's the main gear bay, so I'm not sure what they're for. Again, no ejector pin marks in places they shouldn't be. These, wow, that's a really nice detail in there. There's some in here, but these are going to be covered up, so you're not going to really see them. Let me show you a detail I was talking about. So, the detail in there, the fuel probe, another joystick. Detail in there. So, you see that fine detail in there? Looking good. There you can see the ejector pin marks, but they're going to be covered. And there's the front landing gear strut, bulkhead, second instrument panel. Jet nozzles, nice detail on the side of those. Here's the double cockpit. According to the picture, it's a single seat, so we'll find out. More compressor blades, or did I ever say that once before? It's the same ones. Let's see. Yep. Compressor blades. Here's the detail of the landing gear bay. Lots of fine molded detail in this sprue. Struts and everything else. And this was the other sprue that was in it. So what I was wrong before, that was for the two-seat version. This is for the single-seat version. Here, it looks like the floor of the cockpit. This looks like the part that's going to hold up the canopy or the speed brake. Not sure which. I think this is the part that goes over and makes it a single seat version. So, you can see the detail in there where you're going to hook the canopy up to. And there's no burring or flash or anything on those small parts. And this sprue looks like it's got jet intakes, pylons, and fuel tanks. Nice bit of raised and recessed details. Actually, there feels like some nice, good texture on the fuel tanks. Jet intakes, obviously you're going to have to do a little work to make them seamless, but they sit back, so it's hard to tell how good they're, how far back they're going to be. Pylons, two-piece pylons. I'm not sure what these small, delicate parts are, but they are very delicate and fine. So there you go with your fuel tank details. So there's three fuel tanks. Two wing, one center line. Here's those small, delicate, fragile parts I told you about. Not sure where they're going. Intakes. Inside the intakes. One advantage is there are no ejector pin marks inside these intakes at all. Either one. They did jobs of putting them all around, but not inside. There's the detail on the pylons. Two halves each. Yeah, I'm impressed with that sprue and the way they thought out the intakes. Very nice. And it's like, I miscounted the number of sprues, that's for sure. Need to learn my ABCs a little bit better. Oh, sorry. That would be 1, 2, 3s. All right, this one has 2 in it as well. So, here it is. Wingtips, it looks like, for the folding wings. The other side of the nose, where you saw the one side. I'm not sure where these parts go, but they're very nicely detailed. These are going to be parts for the wing folds. I'm thinking these are parts for the engines. And flaps or ailerons. So you want to be careful removing these from the sprue so you don't break off any of the parts if you're going to have the wings folded. So I'm not sure if we're going to have to cut the ends of the one wings off to use these. Probably. There's the detail on the wing, the outer wings. And the flaps or ailerons. And then the top detail on the folded wings. More of the parts, I'm not sure. Like I said, I think these are engines, but I'm not sure. They've got nice texture inside of them. These do have ejector pin marks, so I'm not sure if you're going to see the inside. Here's the other parts of the wings. The nose. The dog barking. And these are some more of the parts for the mechanism for the wing fold. Second sprue that was in that bag looks like another tail, another nose, and some more landing gear struts. Check something out while I've got all these parts in the bag. So now we're comparing these. This is the extra one. The landing gear struts look the same. This nose looks, there you go. This has got that window in it I told you that was Canadian one version, I thought. And this one doesn't have the window, it's got the full panel. But you could have the cutout for the window if you want to do it. So there's part, that's the reason for this one being different. The tails. Don't really see any difference, but I could be wrong. Interesting. Anyway, we know for sure that the nose is a little different because of that window. Struts look the same. Except, nope. Yep. These have holes in them. Right here. These do not. So there is a difference. And the last one. This has got the wheels, a bunch of little fiddly antenna parts. Here's your overall look at that one. Guessing these are engine parts. These are for the pylons to mount the weapons on. This sprue may have a lot of parts you don't use for this kit because you don't have weapons on it. I'm not sure if the pylons will stay on it. There's the front wheels. There's the back wheels, separate hubs, so it'll make it easier to paint. Gear doors, nicely detailed inside with no ejector pin marks on any of them. See, nice ridge detail on there. So let's zoom on down here and you can see pylons other tips, another pylon. I'm not sure what those are. Probably antennas. The wheel hubs. Very nice two-sided. See there and there and there and there. Then you turn them over and you got brake detail, lug nut detail. These are for the main ones. The wheels have no flat spots or in halves, but you can work that out. The gear bay doors, all around there. Those parts for the engine, the exhaust, I'm assuming. Turn it over, you can see nice detail inside the exhaust. Move to some gear doors. No ejector pin marks and nice details, and that can be said for all of these gear doors. No ejector pin marks, nice details. So, Kinetic is keeping up their standards and making some really nice plastic. If it goes together as well as their other F-18 kits, it'll be a beautiful thing when you're done with it. Photo etch, heads-up display, parts, rearview mirrors and stuff for the glass, vents, a little bit of wiring it looks like, no belts. And two sets of clear sprues. Looks like this one has got the front windscreen. And that one window or camera for the side. Well, that's this one here. Landing lights. Front windscreen. There's a center seam through, but it's supposed to be there because there's a line going down the center. But very clear, very nice. Let's just slide over my Edward Kaffir that I'm working on instructions. You can see no real distortion in that. Little bit because of the curve. That in there. And this that was out of the bag when I got it is the main canopy. It has a center seam running all the way down it. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be there or not, but I'll look before I go crazy and sand it out. Because, you know, the A10 does have a center seam that's supposed to be there. This is much clearer than the front one. And it is a single seat canopy, as you can tell. I didn't get scratched or anything, fortunately. Put these back under here. Alright, let's check out some instructions. Zoom out. A little about this, 150th anniversary of the Confederation, specially painted. Official logo of Kinetic Canada 150. Beautiful. It's giving you a little about the tools needed, some of the rules to follow. Open it up. It's got a sprue map that's not numbered. And it doesn't mark what you're not going to use. These are aftermarket service cards. So if you lose something and you need a new sprue, here's the code for it. Quantity, item number. If you damage or something came damaged. The instructions, starting with the ejection seat. There's the seat cushion. Doesn't look like it has any belts on it, so you're going to need to either use some tape or some milliputty or get some Edward. This picture shows belts right here, but I do not see where they are unless they're decals. So, you're only using the front one. The painting instructions. Looks like they're using MIG color callouts. Here's that part that goes over the back back cockpit, sidewalls for the cockpit. Intakes, single stage compressor blade, then the exhaust, the fans, more painting instructions, very detailed painting instructions for the wheel wells and for the cockpit. Everything going into the bottom of the fuselage. Refueling probe, open or closed. Nose, bulkhead. This is showing you, what's that symbol? Drill. Drill out the holes right here before you put it together. There's that clear part going in there. You have to mask it off before you paint it. Here's those parts going in for the intake. Like I said, you won't see the inside of that, so those ejector pin marks there aren't a problem. Cockpit going in, nose cone going on. Doesn't say anything about weight. I'm not sure how much weight you'll need for an F-18, but I'm sure there's some. Wings going on to the upper fuselage. Here's wing extended, wing folded. It does not say, well, I guess that symbol means optional, but it doesn't say to cut it. But there's the line to cut it right there, and there's where you would glue in that one part that goes for the wing fold. So yes, you will have to cut the wing tips off for both of these here too. But it's a detailed groove, sharp blade, you should be fine. Putting the two halves together, flaps, ailerons, flapperons. Looks like you are putting the pylons on, all of them. So you're going to need, well, it doesn't say to drill out the holes, but if you want those on there, well, these are the control surfaces for the flaps and ailerons. My mistake, not pylons. And it shows you the adjustable angle for the flaps and ailerons. Flap up, flap down. Very nice. Folded wings. So this shows you the assembly for the folded wings. So you're not going to assemble them yet. You're just going to put those two halves together. Then you're going to assemble them using that one part. Two wing halves together up there. There's a PE part there. Then the flaps you're going to attach. Ailerons, the flaps. Leading edge slats. Looks like there's a gap and it's showing you the position. And the wings are folded. I don't think I'll fold the wings on mine because I want the color scheme just to stand out. Here's the other cover part to keep it as a single seater. There are, this is how you assemble the tails and they go in there. Elevators, still telling you the MIG color callouts. Closed canopy with this part down, open canopy with this part up. Heads up display, clear glass, PE going on there. Oh, this page looks really busy. Fortunately, you can do the landing gear after it's all painted. It shows you the correct angles of the gear and the doors for the back, the main gear. Lots of little bits going into putting all the gear together. Then you got antennas, more antennas. Well, like I said, all the gear can wait till the end. PE parts are going right here over those two vents. PE parts here and here going underneath the wings. There's a boarding ladder included. That's what some of those parts were for. So you have a boarding ladder. Here's the color callouts. Ammo, Vallejo, Mr. Color, Tamiya, and Humbrol. MIG and Vallejo are the only ones that have the complete list of all of these color callouts. Now you can see that, but let's bring it up so you can freeze it. That's a lot of colors. And painting guide, not in color. So, it says AMIG-049, just red. So I would compare, because you're gonna have to match it up to these decal colors. Let's leave this here. These are cartograph decals, so they're going to be good. This is the red. And this is the red. These are the tails. This is the part that goes over the fuselage. Here. Just like that. So, you're going to have to paint this red, which it looks like Let me check the guide. 096. No, that's for periscope. So it looks like the whole thing is painted the same color red on top. And it's got to match this color red. Now I like that they did the fading. Because doing this fading, some talented modeler can do it, but I don't think I could do it. And this is the outside, this is the inside of the wings. This is the outside. One of these is for the inside. You can see you've got the detail there. This whole thing. So from here to here is one part of the decal. And that's separate, that's separate, that's separate. Then this is one part, this is one part, this is one part, and this is one part. So fortunately it's not all in one piece, but you already have to take your time and see none of these lines are connecting. But you look here, they're all attaching, so you just have to make sure you line them all up right. These are in halves, which are for here. Then you've got the big ones for the elevators, which is these two. This white here looks like this part down here, which I'd probably, well, no. Unless you're going to cut that out, you can't really paint it. So here's where the jet intake part goes, which is here. And then this part's going to go along here. Walkways, I'm guessing. I'm sorry, walkways, a few stencils. Yep, there's the seat belts. So they do give you decals. And actually, looking at it, here's the jet intakes. Here's the Royal Canadian Air Force. So you can paint it because they're giving you the separate decals. Very good touch, Kinetic. Some people won't want to decal that. Very nice touch. But you have to paint it white anyway for the tail, the wing tips. Well, actually they gave you decals for the wing tips. And the tail's got the white part. So you can do this whole thing without painting it white, just red and gray, top and bottom. But I'm gonna paint this white too. And then use these extra decals. And that's it. Complex decal scheme, beautiful aircraft. I'm gonna thoroughly enjoy this. The Royal Canadian Air Force demo team from 2017 for the 150th anniversary of the Confederate, whatever that means, Confederation. So there you go. Hope you enjoyed this Sprue review. I'd suggest buy one, because I don't think these are going to be around long. And if you're like me and you've got the Oregon National Guard F-15 Eagle, they'd look beautiful sitting side by side. Thanks. Remember, don't be a kit collector, be a kit builder. Go out there and pick up something fancy and build it today. Thanks for watching.